Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will not be dealing with the lead editorial, rather I will be dealing with a very important topic that is important from current affairs point of view. Primarily it relates to general studies mains examination paper 2, and the name of the topic is special category status and the difference it has with the special status state. Now of late we have been reading a lot about article 370 and article 35A. Now in newspapers we have been reading about this article, and this article relates to the special status that has been accorded to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So this article 370, it was added to the Indian constitution when the Indian constitution came into being on 26th of January 1950. So this was the specific date of January 26th, 1950 when this article 370 came into being. So this is very important thing. Now this article 370 was added as a temporary article in the Indian constitution to accord special status to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. As per this article 370, there were four subjects that the government of India, that the Union government of India had kept with itself, and rest all the subjects were transferred to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. For normal states, we had subjects like union list, concurrent list and state list. But for this Jammu and Kashmir assembly, just four subjects were kept with the union government, with the central government. These four subjects were, the first was defense, second was finance, third was foreign relations, and fourth was communication. DFFC. So these were the four subjects that were kept with the central government, with the union government. Rest of the subjects were transferred to the states. So this was the basic provision of article 370. So special status was given to the state of Jammu and Kashmir as per article 370. Now this is an added provision to article 370, that is article 335A, subsection A. Now this relates to the power to the legislative assembly of the Jammu and Kashmir, by which they have been allowed to give and accord citizenship to the citizens just belonging to Jammu and Kashmir, to decide about the domicile provisions. So this power has been also accorded to Jammu and Kashmir state. So this article 370, it entirely relates to the special status to Jammu and Kashmir. On the other hand, we also have a distinct type of category, that is special category states. Now this special category states is entirely different from this article 370. Now what is the special category status? Special category states, or special category status, special status or special category, this is entirely different. Now before the 14th Finance Commission's recommendations came into being, we were having this distinction between normal states and special category states. But after the recommendation of the 14th Finance Commission has been accepted, we don't have anything like special category states as of now. Now what were these special category states? These were such states which were actually low in term of resource, which were having low population, the states whose topography was not right, the states which had large number of tribal population. So these were the conditions by which the special category status was accorded to certain states. States which were hilly. So these were the reasons for which the special category status was accorded. Now, why this status was accorded to the states? Now, this is important, the reason. Now, the first four and foremost reason for this was that this status was accorded because these states, they were low in term of resources, low population was there, topography was not right, tribal population used to be there, and economic condition was not fine. So in order to streamline these states with the mainstream states, the special provision was added in 1969 on the recommendation of the 5th Finance Commission. Now, as per this special category states, these states were given more in terms of grants. So whatever used to be the government's policy or program, 90% of that was financed by way of grants. But for the normal state, it used to be just 30%. And 10% was given in terms of loan. And in the normal states, it was 70% in terms of loan. Now, how the resources should be divided further were decided by the Gadzil formula. So it was the Gadzil formula that used to decide about how the finances should be divided between the center and the state depending upon this criteria. Now, of late, we have been reading a lot about this Article 370, but this has got nothing to do with the special category states. Now, all these things, they can be changed by way of amendment. And already they have been done away with the status that was accorded to the special category states. And on the other hand, we also have special provisions for certain states. Now, this is mentioned under Article 371 from A till J. Article 370, it relates to Gujarat and Maharashtra. Article 371 and from A till J, it relates to the northeastern states and the states like Jammu and Kashmir, Sikkim, Assam, etc. and Uttarakhand. Now, with respect to the states that are added in the special provision category, these states, they have been given special power and privilege to manage the affairs of their own states. And these states, they have been added in the special category provision. Special provisions have been added because they are actually distinct, because India is a diverse country with having diverse needs, and these states, they have a diverse needs. The states lying in the northeast of the India, they have a diverse needs with respect to their customary laws, with respect to the law and order situation, with respect to the development, with respect to the welfare of those states, and with respect to the governmental structures. So all these provisions have been added in the Indian Constitution. So in this class, we've learned basically the three type of differences: special provisions of the various states that were part of the temporary and the transitory phase. And we have also learned about the special category status, that is 370, and we have also learned about special category states. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact us at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And you can also order the video classes on BrainyIAS.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is IAS Buzz. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.